be discussing the issue that's really close to his heart, the recent developments in the West Philippine Sea and the reported harassment of Filipino fishermen in Scarborough Shoal. CJ, the latest issue has to do with the Sandy Cay. All right, let's discuss the Sandy Cay issue, which is 2 nautical miles from Pag-asa in the Spratlys, still on the West Philippine Sea, but on the Spratlys side, where President Duterte supposedly stopped patrols in the West Philippine side already. And why should we be worried when it comes to Sandy Cay at this point?
Well, we should be worried because Sandy Cay is now land. It's now territory.
Okay.
Because before it used to be low tide, high tide, but because of the action of the waves, the sand in Subi Reef drifted to Sandy Cay, and Sandy Cay now is permanently above water at high tide. Yeah. So it's now land. It's entitled to 12 nautical miles territorial sea. And it's only 2 nautical miles from Pag-asa. So if China controls and claims and has sovereignty over Sandy Cay, the territorial sea of Pag-asa will be split. 1/3 of the territorial sea of Pag-asa will go to Sandy Cay. So the Philippines will lose about 1/3 of its territorial sea in Pag-asa, and that's about 51,000 hectares, more than 3 times the size of Quezon City. So it's a huge area that we will lose. Now, the tribunal said Pag-asa has a territorial sea that reaches Subi Reef.
Yeah.
And now, because of Sandy Cay, Sandy Cay will have its own territorial sea. The Subi Reef will now form part of the territorial sea of Sandy Cay.
Yeah.
So if China controls Sandy Cay, their presence in Subi Reef will be legitimized.
Okay. You've heard already the argument or the debate between DFA Secretary Alan Cayetano and Congressman Alejandro regarding who's controlling Sandy Cay. Okay, are we first agreeing on Chinese presence in Sandy Cay?
Well,
before we continue our discussion.
Well, even the president said that he was asked, and this is in the newspapers, the president was asked about the presence of Chinese Coast Guard vessels in Sandy Cay. And he said, they are there to patrol because they are my friends and they are not claiming anything. But of course, China claimed 85.5% of the South China Sea in 2009. China filed a claim with the United Nations, which is official notice to the Philippines. And the presence of Chinese Coast Guard vessels anywhere within the 9-dash line is to enforce their claim under the 9-dash line. So when Chinese Coast Guard vessels go to the West Philippine Sea, they don't have to say we are claiming this because they already claimed that.
They're before actually,
yes,
yeah.
And they're enforcing their claim. When we see their vessels in the West Philippine Sea, that is enforcement of their claim. And that's why we have to protest every time they do that.
Yeah. So I think you're making a strong point. It is not about either them declaring that it's ours anymore or them even fishing in Subi Reef or Sandy Cay. Mere presence alone should not be accepted by the Philippines?
Yes, because first of all, Sandy Cay is within the territorial sea of Pag-asa. Territorial sea is like land territory. There are two kinds of territories over which we have sovereignty. The land, we have sovereignty over that. It's called land territory. Sea territory, we have sovereignty over that. It's the territorial sea. It's like land because it's territory. And China is now patrolling our territorial sea, which should never happen because that's we have sovereignty over that.
Yeah.
And the president said they are there to patrol. We should not allow that.
Yeah.
Because especially
we should patrol it ourselves.
We should patrol it ourselves, and not only that, because China is claiming it, we should not allow it to patrol. Because if we allow China to patrol, they will later on say, "Oh, you already agreed that we own this because we are patrolling it now." So we should be very careful in allowing anything that China would interpret later as acquiescence to their claim.
Okay. Now, I got this question last night. Can the people of the Philippines file a protest against China with the arbitral court if the head of state, President Duterte, refuses to?
Well,
what's left for us?
Unfortunately, only states, governments are parties to the UNCLOS convention, and only member states can file cases there.
Yeah.
But what we can do is educate everybody, educate the world that no country can own one sea. I mean, the last time that a country tried to claim the oceans and seas was in the 1500s, Spain and Portugal, but that has been quashed for all time by Hugo Grotius, the father of international law. The oceans and seas beyond the territorial sea belong to mankind.
Yeah.
That's part of the global commons. And China is saying no. South China Sea is ours.
Okay.
And that's why you have the naval powers of the world sailing in the South China Sea, because they don't want China to claim that they own the South China Sea.
But then, given the situation that the Philippines, the government at present, will not file a protest against this or raise any concerns with the with China patrolling Sandy Cay, what's left to do? Plain education.
Yes, we will have to educate everybody so that the Filipino people will understand that that is not acceptable, because we could lose one-third of the territorial sea of Pag-asa, and we should protest. Now, the Secretary Cayetano said that he has filed 50 to 100 protests. I would like to know if it included Sandy Cay.
Yeah, okay. All right. On